In this screencast, we're going to look at three different correlations for cylinders in crossflow, as well as one for a sphere in crossflow. And we're going to discuss the advantages and disadvantages of each one. So the first one, which is known as the Hilpert correlation, as shown here, is the least complicated of all the correlations we could look at. And so this gives us a Nusselt number. And the reason we're looking for the Nusselt number is in order to calculate convective heat transfer, we need to use Newton's law of cooling, which involves that H bar or that convective heat transfer coefficient. And the bar over the H indicates that it's an average heat transfer coefficient. So in order to get that H bar, we need a Nusselt number. And Nusselt numbers are found through different empirical correlations. So this first one, as I said, is the least complicated. And you look up your C and your M, which are both constants, based on the Reynolds number. The advantage of this particular one is that it can be used, so you can find a C as well as an M for geometries that are non-circular. In other words, everything from square to even a thin plate perpendicular to the flow. The next correlation, which is known as the Zukauskas correlation, is slightly more complicated, but again has two constants, C and M, that are based on the Reynolds number, and a third constant, that N, and that N is based on the Prandtl number. So you use the N is equal to 0.37, if the Prandtl number is less than 10. Otherwise, if the Prandtl number is greater than 10, you use N equals 0.36. You look up your C and your M, again, based on the Reynolds number, in a table. The one other difference besides that N is this ratio of Prandtl numbers, where you're looking at the Prandtl at the bulk temperature divided by the Prandtl number at the surface of your cylinder. Finally, we have what's known as the Churchill-Bernstein correlation. And as you can see, this is the most complex of all of them. And here, we have a correlation that's based on the Reynolds number as well as on the Prandtl number. A number of people consider this to be the most accurate of the three. Certainly the second and third ones are better because they're based on more recent results. One question that is always asked about these correlations that have different properties, and the properties are found not only, and let's go back here to our equation for our heat transfer coefficient. And if you notice, we'll need this thermal conductivity of the fluid. But in addition, notice that all of these are functions of the Reynolds number, and the Reynolds number is equal to the velocity times the diameter divided by the kinematic viscosity. So we have to look up the kinematic viscosity at the proper temperature as well. So let's start with the Hilpert correlation that can also be used for non-circular cylinders. And what we do is here we look up the properties at the film temperature, which is equal to the surface temperature plus the bulk temperature divided by 2. And these temperatures need to be in Kelvin. So for this correlation, the properties are found at T infinity, except for our Prandtl at the surface, which is looked up at the surface temperature. And finally, in this correlation, everything here is looked up at T infinity. Finally, we take a look at two correlations for spheres, one which is very general, and so this, known as the Whitaker correlation, is the only one that's used really for spheres. However, we have a very specific correlation that's used for what's known as freely falling drops, and this one is, as you can see, a very simplified version of the Whitaker correlation. So in subsequent screencasts, I'll show you the same problem comparing the different correlations, and we can see how close they are to each other.